Yesterday I said we need a ministry of nomadic affairs. And I saw the news, Bumi saying we need ministry of banditry. So you see, they make banditry synonymous with nomadics. 99.9% of nomadics are peace-loving people. It's only 0.1% that is causing all this havoc. And it's not causing this havoc out of just mere mischief. We have pushed them to the wall. Somebody say they are criminals, but I wonder who is not a criminal. When villagers, we hear in the radio, this governor has stolen this, this accountant has stolen this, this delegate has stolen this, what do you expect him to? He will steal too. It's a nation of stealers. So what do? Let's stop stealing and let's teach morality to them. And the best way is to go to them. When we go there, we tell them, look, it's wrong to steal people. It's wrong to kidnap. It's wrong to take lives. It's wrong to take people's wealth. And they agree with us. The only thing is they give us reason why they do them. And you see, when you are in reconciliation, you accept somebody's reason and gives him a way out. So I hope, inshallah, from today, honestly speaking, we have to engage these people, and I hope that we have positive results. My only fear is the infiltration of terrorists into their midst. I think it's a factor which we have to consider seriously. We have to go in and recapture them from terror. And even the terrorists themselves, I think there's a neglect. Because I had a former president who I spoke with, he told me that he has been to some area whereby he spoke with Boko Haram people and they are ready to put down their arms on conditions. But the government of that day refused to accept such conditions. Up to now, Boko Haram is not a hopeless case. So we have to protect our herdsmen from the infiltration of terrorists. Somebody will say, terrorists, yes, there's terrorism attached to Muslims because the Prophet والسلام, has given us prophecies in the end of the world whereby young men will carry weapons, reading the Quran, but it doesn't go beyond their throat, and they will be killing people. So how do you know that you are an extremist is when you have a gun and killing people, whether Muslims or people under covenant, people under treaty. Like all the non-Muslims we have in Nigeria, there's a treaty with them that we will stay in peace together with them. And this treaty was first contracted by the Waziri of Sokoto, Muhammad Buhari. When the white men came to Sokoto, there was a treaty between them and him that Muslims will stay with non-Muslims in this country under peace and progress. And this treaty has been always renewed up to today. When we elect our delegates into the House of Assembly, into the government, we are also re-emphasizing this treaty that we are going to stay in peace and tranquility with other non-Muslims. So no Muslim has the right to injure, to kill any non-Muslim in this country under that treaty. And the Prophet of Islam has said categorically in hadith, muttafaqun alayhi, and narrated by Bukhari and Muslim, man qatala nafsan mu'ahada lam yarah raihat al-jannah wa inna rihaha la yujadu min masirati 40 aaman. Whoever among you Muslims will kill any soul, he said, any soul that you have treaty of peace, treaty of mutual coexistence, if anybody will kill such a soul, then such Muslim will not even smell the fragrance of paradise. And the fragrance of paradise can be found 40 years of travel away from Jannah. This is trying to show you the extent in which Islam respects treaty. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu awfu bil uqud. All you who believe, you should always keep to your obligations. And we have written constitution that we are going to stay in peace with non-Muslims, so no Muslim has a right to use his hand to kill any non-Muslim. And the Prophet of Islam has said, ذِمَّةُ الْإِسْلَامُ وَاحِدًا ذِمَّةُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَاحِدًا وَيَسْعَى بِهَا أَدْنَاهُمْ. When a Muslim, even the smallest of a Muslim, if he gives his word of covenant and treaty to a non-Muslim, then it's binding on the whole ummah. Yes, I be hard now. Even the smallest, a small boy, if you tell a non-Muslim, come, I will give you my sanctuary, that nobody will touch you, then no Muslim has right to touch him. So we use this forum to call on Nigerians to desist from taking laws into their hand. They should refer everything to the authorities. This is the injunction of Allah, who said, إذا جاءهم أمر من الأمن أو الخوف أذاعوا به ولو ردوه إلى الرسول وإلى أولي الأمر منهم. أولي الأمر منهم, that if anything comes of peace or security or fear, you should return it to the leaders. And this is our leaders. They should also take into cognizance that they need to stand up to their responsibility and deal with people the way it should be done. Thank you very much.